Okay guys, today I'm going to try to solve some nonogram puzzles without using the cross. I'm also going to show you how I solve my nonogram puzzles my way. Okay, so first find the big numbers. I see there's 4, 4, there's a 5, 1, 1, 4, 5. Yeah. So with 4, 5, it's already pretty clear. It should be filling the whole row. But with 4, 4, you can still put it, but you might not know. So my way is, first you add up all the numbers. So 4 and 4 will be 8. And then you add up how many gaps there are between numbers. So in this case, that is a 1. So in total, there will be, so in total it's 9. You check the rows, how many tiles are in it, and you subtract it by the result. That means 1. So it must be, so you can leave one gap on each side. So it should be look like this. Yeah, okay, let's try it with another one. 5, 1, 1. So you add them up first, become 7. There's 2 gaps, so it's a 9. So only one space can be freed. So for something like this, one space freed, you can add 4 to fill it, but for the ones you can't, cause 1 is 1, and if you have 1 gap, you can't just put here. It can be here or here. Yeah, so this only works if the number, if the resulting subtraction number is smaller than the number of tiles in a row. So for something like this, since 1 is already filled here, I can just complete the 5. And by completing the 5, the clue is here, it's 5, so I can put it here, since this is a 3, and to make it a 5, it needs something here, if the 5 is in this row. Okay, so by doing that, you can also put the 2 here. Okay, let's find another big one. 4, 1, 1, 6, 7, 8, 2 gaps. Okay, from here, I can see there's 2 and a 1 separated by the gap. And from what I can see here, it's a 1, 3, and 2. So there can be no, so there no longer can be any tiles here. It will not satisfy these requirements. So that means this must be the 3, this must be the 2. And by that logic, this should be the 1. And since this is already filled, this is the 3. Since this is 3 filled, 1 filled, there must not be any tiles here, so we can complete the 5. 2 rows done, a couple more to go. Wait, 2 rows done, a couple more columns done. Yeah, it's pretty simple. Okay, next. You see here, 5. There must be, that must mean there's nothing here. So the only region we can put the 4 is in these 6 tiles. Apply that to what I said. So 6 minus 4 is a 2. So that must be 2 gaps on this, on each side. Must makes it like this. And I can also rule out this spot, because there's already a tile here and it's a 1, so there must be nothing here. I can put a tile right beside it. Okay, let's check for more. 2 and a 4. 6. 7. It's a 3 gap. Okay, one more completed. Since, yeah, see here is a 3 gap, I put 1 tile here, this must be the 4, since this row is filled, so I can just put 4 here and then 2. And by this, I can see that 2 is somewhere here, this is, and 3 is up here. Just fill in the gaps, 4, 4, 4, got it. It's also complete, so 4 must be there, complete, so this is a gap, so this must be the 3, this must be the 2, and this must be the 1. Yeah, I should have gotten this earlier, since this is one complete set. Okay, another one. This must be the 3, 4, 4. That must be the 4, that must be the 1. 3, 4. Completed. Now I must find the 1 for that. Should be here. And we are done, correct. That should be it. It's pretty easy, isn't it? Okay, see you.